Welcome to my channel, I'm Dr. Ford. And today we're going to touch on a really important topic, which is COVID. One of the many questions that I've been getting as a pediatrician and a neonatologist is, how does COVID affect babies? As a pediatrician and a neonatologist and a parent, I'm very interested in finding out more about COVID and how it can affect babies. So if you're interested in this topic, or if you have a baby and you really want to know, please stick around. We're going to answer this right now. SARS-CoV-2, or severe acute respiratory syndrome coronavirus 2, is the name of the organism causing the infection. The actual symptoms that you get from it is the COVID-19, as in coronavirus 2019 infection. So the topic of whether SARS-CoV-2 can infect babies, either passing from the mother to the baby or the babies itself, is extremely important, and everybody really wants to know, including myself. As a neonatologist, this is one of those topics that I've been constantly reading about, trying to capture as much information, and there isn't a whole lot. But what better person or specialist to answer that than infectious disease specialist? So to answer these important questions, I invited Dr. Juan Dumois, who is a pediatric infectious disease specialist, to answer the questions regarding COVID-19, SARS-CoV-2, and babies. So I'm going to go ahead and pose the questions to him, and he has been gracious enough through the computer, because obviously we have to all do social distancing, answer these questions for us.
Hello, I'm Dr. Juan Dumois. I'm a pediatric infectious diseases doctor, and I'll be answering some questions today about COVID-19 for Dr. Ford's Baby Talk.
So one of the mothers asked, if I am pregnant with COVID-19, can I pass this to my baby?
Now the first thing I want to say is that the pandemic is not over. So you still have to be careful when you leave home with social distancing and wearing a mask and cleaning your hands with soap and water or hand sanitizer when you go out. You really don't want to get infected when you're pregnant. Pregnant women who get coronavirus and a bunch of other viruses tend to get sicker because pregnancy weakens your immune system a little bit. So it's better to avoid these infections altogether. Now, one of the questions that we get is, can a newborn baby be infected with COVID-19 if the mother has it? And the answer is a definite yes. That's been proven that some newborn babies tested positive for the coronavirus when it was known that the mother had COVID-19. The mother was obviously sick enough to get tested, but it's interesting that very often the newborn babies had no symptoms at all.
I've heard that in general, babies don't get sick. Is this true?
If a baby gets COVID-19 in the first few months of life, they can sometimes get sick, and they can sometimes get very sick, sick enough to end up in the hospital.
One key question was, if I have COVID-19 and I am breastfeeding, can I pass this to my baby?
Well, we do want the baby to keep drinking breast milk. They can drink formula, but breast milk is usually better for most babies. But what's recommended is that the mother pump her breast milk and that somebody else feeds it to her, and that should go on for 10 days after the mother got sick. Now, there may be some situations where that's just not possible, that there's no one else who can feed the baby the breast milk, or the mother just refuses to do that. In those cases, what's recommended is that before holding the baby, the mother wash her hands, she puts on a mask, and then nurses her baby. And the other thing that's important there is don't kiss the baby. Kissing the baby is something you want to do, but it is not helpful for the baby. So avoid kissing the baby when you're sick.
Another parent wants to know, if their baby was exposed to someone with COVID-19, what do they have to do?
Well, you don't want to rush out and have your baby tested for COVID-19 if they're doing fine. That really is not helpful because your baby may test negative one day and be positive the next. So what's more important is you monitor your baby for developing any symptoms of illness, and that's for 14 days after they last had contact with that person who has COVID-19. So for those 14 days, you're going to be looking for different symptoms of illness, and in babies, that can be fever, the baby can be irritable, they may not be feeding quite well, they may be sleeping more than usual. Anything that seems a little bit off is enough reason to take your baby in to be checked by the pediatrician. And the pediatrician then decides if they would get tested for COVID-19 or maybe a whole bunch of other types of infections that can make a baby sick.
Another question we got was, what type of testing do they do for babies?
If a baby does need to be tested for COVID-19, the right test is the swab, the nasal swab that goes in the nose. That looks for the virus causing the infection. And that's the standard test done in most people. Some people have asked, can you do the blood antibody test in babies to see if they've been infected? And that is not a useful test. The reason for that is that babies are born with antibodies in their blood that they got from the mother. So for the last couple of months of pregnancy, protective antibodies from the mother's blood are crossing the placenta into the baby so that the baby is born with a lot of this kind of protection from the mother. And that protection disappears after several months to a year. But at birth, there are all those antibodies there. And if the mother had COVID-19, and she has antibodies in her blood, those will be in the baby. And if you do the antibody test in the baby and you get a positive result, you're probably detecting the mother's antibodies. So again, the blood test for COVID-19 is not going to be useful for most babies. I hope that this information was useful for you, and thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Dr. Dumois, for answering these excellent questions that people posted. Again, I really appreciate you joining our channel and giving us all this great information, very useful information. We may reach out to you later as we update some of this information on COVID and babies. What are the general symptoms of babies, if any? So in looking at the studies, when you look at small studies and you put them together and try and make a large one, something called a meta-analysis, they have actually shown approximately 5-6% of babies whose mothers had COVID-19 infection also got the infection. What's interesting is that actually the babies don't seem to, even though they have the infection, they don't seem to be symptomatic, meaning they don't really show any symptoms. As they get a little bit older though, they can begin to show some symptoms. Fevers, chills, decreased activity, decreased feeding. They can have mild upper respiratory symptoms, things like runny nose, things that you would expect with a regular cold. All the studies that have documented infection in babies, there doesn't seem to be major complications or any deaths or illnesses. There have been some deaths reported in babies less than 1 year of age, but they're still currently under investigation. So in time, we'll know more what the actual infection rates are for babies, how do they present, and what we can do to try and prevent that. So as we get more information on COVID-19, on SARS-CoV-2, and how it affects babies, I'll be posting more videos. If you have any questions, please add them to the comment section. I'd be happy to answer those as well. Thank you so much for watching. Again, I'm Dr. Ford. Please, if you like this video, go ahead and hit like, hit the notification button. That way you'll know as soon as I post something. And please subscribe, really helps me out. So thank you again. It's been a pleasure. We'll see you with the next video.